Welcome to the video lecture of Computer Networks. I'm Sujita, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, NPR College of Engineering and Technology, going to present this lecture. So today in this lecture, we are going to discuss about Unit 1, Introduction and Physical Layer. In this, we are going to discuss about the topic called Protocol Layering. So let me discuss about the protocol layering. So this is about an protocol layering. So what is this protocol layering? Why in a computer networks this protocol layering plays a major role? So in data communication and networking, the protocol, what is meant by protocol? The protocol that defines a set of rules that both sender and receiver and all the intermediate devices need to follow for the effective communication to take place. So when a communication is simple, we need only one simple protocol. But when the communication is more complex, we may need to divide the task into several layers. So for that protocol, for in this case, we need protocol at each layer. So that is why we are calling this as an protocol layering. For the complex systems to divide the task, the protocol layering approach has been devised. So that is the main purpose of protocol layering, is to divide the complex task into simpler one. So to better understand the protocol layering, let me discuss about the scenarios of protocol layering. So first scenario, let me consider two scenarios. In the first scenario, for one is for simple protocol and another one is for complex systems, how the protocol layering influences in this approach. So first scenario, in the first scenario, communication is so simple so that it can occur only in a one layer. So there is no need to divide the layers into two parts. So here only one layer approach. It is very communication is simple. The communications between takes place only between the two peoples, and only here it influences and only one layer. So that is the face to face communications. So here you can see it is a single layer protocol. In the single layer protocol, you can see ARIA and MAN. So the two peoples are exchange the messages. So here there is no need to split the tasks into two parts. The next one is about second scenario. So even in a simple scenario, first we'll see this single layer protocol in detail. So even this in a simple scenario, we can need to set some certain number of rules. First, the both peoples need to greet each other. So these are all the one of the rule we need to fix it. And second one, they need to confine their vocabulary to the level of their friendship. And third one, they need they each should refrain from their speaking when other party is speaking. The both of listening and understanding should be in clear. And fourth one is each party's conversation should be a dialogue, not a monologue. So these all things should be included in a rules. That is why these all should be in a frames. And fifth one, they should exchange some nice words when they leave. So these are all some set of rules need to be followed in a simple scenarios. And coming to the part of second scenario, it uses encryption and decryption techniques. First, the sender encrypts the letter to make it unreadable by the intruder. The receiver of the letter then decrypts to get the original letter. So same like it is going to happening between the same two peoples. One technique that makes too hard to decrypt the letter, if one does not have the key for doing. So if doesn't having the encrypt key, so we cannot decrypt the letter. So that is the hard thing here we are facing. And now the communication is takes place between in this decryption technique, encryption and decryption techniques in a three layers. So only if it is between the two peoples, it will take it in a single layer. But if this here the encryption and decryption is going to happen, so it takes in a three layers. So let me discuss about what how it is going. So you can see this diagram. In this diagram, you can see this three layers. First one is and send receive, encrypt decrypt, and finally we'll be having a listening and talk. So first in this send mail or receive mail, the both should be send the messages. So that message should be encrypted by the sender, that should be decrypted by the receiver. Either the receiver can send the encryption message and the sender can decrypt. Likewise, it should be in both communication identical manner. And third one, they should have a plain text. So this both text should be in a same. So in the scenario, we are going to divide this complex task into smaller tasks to prefer a better understanding. So only in the present situation, they need to change the second layer machine. This is we can refer as a modularity. Modularity in the sense it plays only for an independent layers. So the layer can be defined as a black box with the inputs and outputs, with concern about the input, how the output is changing. So that is what we are saying here. Modularity. If two machines provide the same outputs when they given input, then they can replace with each other. So that is the process will be continued in the modularity. So this is about a second scenario. So let's coming to the last part of protocol layering, pros and cons. That is an advantage and disadvantage. It allows us to separate the services from the implementations. Apart from the implementation, it separates the services. And the communication does not always use only two end systems that are intermediate systems that need only some layers but not all layers. So that is the major advantage in the protocol layering, because it enables between these two systems. The intermediate systems only need some layers, but it doesn't concern about an other layers. And third one is about there is no need for each layer to provide a services to the upper layer and give services to the lower layer. So this is a major disadvantage, because here coming to the layering part, the services must be provided by the upper layer and also in the lower layer, but in this protocol approach that is not possible. So that is the disadvantage in the protocol layering. And let me discuss about the principles of protocol layering. Here we'll be having two principles. One is an bidirectional communication and another one is an identical. The first principle we are going to discuss about is in bidirectional communication. So in this bidirectional communication, if you want a bidirectional communication, we need each layer that is to perform opposite task only in each direction. So bidirectional is both directions the communication is going to take place. And this identical, two objects under each layer at both sides should be in an identical manner. So that is the second principles of an protocol layering. Then another logical connection. So what does mean by logical connections? This means we are having an communication in the layer to layer. So consider the two peoples Maria and Anne. Then think that is a logical connection, that is an imaginary connection at each layer. So which they can send object created from the each layer. We will see the concept of logical layer for better understanding of tasks of each layer. So for data communication and networking, for a better understanding of protocol layering, we are having an logical connections. So only it is to create for each layer. The logical connection is established between in each layers. So this is about a logical connection between peer-to-peer process, because the same diagram which we have seen in second scenario, it is used here. here the logical connection, how the logical connection is made between, because from each layers, from the sender side and the receiver side, here you can see encryption and decryption, the same ciphertext, and the here also will be a same ciphertext. That is why we are called as an identical, and we are having an bidirectional communication. So that is why these two combinedly we can call it as a logical connection. So you can see this, all the three layers are having an logical connections. That is why it is called as a peer layers. Thank you. That's all about the protocol layering approaches. Thank you. Thank you for watching the video.